Hi, I'm Dr. Sreenivasa Murthy T M and Senior ENT Consultant at Ashwanpur. I practice at Sreenivasa Specialty ENT Center, my clinic in Ashwanpur, and at Columbia Asia Referral Hospital, Ashwanpur. Now, the ear is divided into the outer ear, the middle ear, and the inner ear. Now, the middle ear is connected to the nose on one side by means of a tube called Eusatchian tube. It is in continuum with the bone behind the ear called the mastoid bone. So this middle ear is called as a tympanum. Now infections in the ear, generally middle ear, generally occur secondary to infections in the nose. So somebody having a cold, they try to blow their nose. Along with blowing the secretions out, they will be blowing some amount of those infected secretions through the Eusatchian tube into the middle ear, and hence the Eusatchian tube and the middle ear gets infected. Now when that happens, they will initially have some pain, followed by severe pain, a fever, pain behind the ear, around the ear, muffling of sounds, that means hearing will become slightly blocked, and if neglected for more than a day or two, then there is formation of pus in the middle ear. And hence it has to come out somewhere. It ruptures through the eardrum and then comes out through the ear. So when the ear membrane ruptures, they will suddenly notice that all the pain that they had reduces, and they will start seeing a blood-stained pus-like material coming out of their ear. Now this is called acute suppurative otitis media. Now when this happens, people can also have other complications if not managed at the right time. There are certain other structures in the middle ear which can get infected, like the facial nerve can get infected. You can have facial paralysis. The inner ear can get infected through the middle ear, causing what is called as labyrinthitis, in which case patient can have giddiness. So these are unusual, but these are the means by which infection can spread. Now, when acute suppurative otitis media is not treated adequately, or if the hole tends to persist and not close, then there is a chance that the patient can have infections again and again for two reasons. With every infection of the upper respiratory tract, like when they have a cold and sore throat, or whenever water enters their ear when they are having a bath, then there is another source of infection into the middle ear. Then again they will have ear discharge, pain, noises in the ear, hearing loss, and if this continues multiple times, then again the duration is 3 months. If it is there for more than 3 months, then we would call it as chronic suppurative otitis media. So based on the duration, we will name it as either acute, subacute, or chronic.